let's take a look at the annotation tools you can use on your virtual whiteboard. The two most important tools you'll need are the pencil for underlining and drawing, and the text tool for adding text. Whenever you add an annotation to the whiteboard, you can think of it as creating an object. The object can then be selected, moved, resized, and deleted. The whiteboard tools button is on the bottom left of your whiteboard. You may have some different options depending on your school's or account settings. At the top, we have the color tool. I can change to a different color, which is nice. If I want to change the color of an existing annotation, simply select it and choose a new color here. Next, we have this pointer, which allows me to select and move objects. There's also the option to move the canvas, whether that's a PDF file or just the whiteboard background. Then you can click here to reset it back to its original position. The corrections tools give me some little stickers. You have ticks, crosses, and stars. My young learners really love these. Next up is shapes. We have lines, arrows, boxes, circles, and fill boxes, and filled circles. After that, we have the drawing tools. The pencil creates a line. The highlighter creates a thicker line, which is a bit transparent. And the eraser creates a thick white line. It's handy for some things, but I find that white filled boxes are actually better for covering up large areas or neatly erasing a word, for example. Then we have the text tool. You can add some text, change the format to bold, italic, underline, or strike through. The pointer tool is used to draw attention to a particular area and will also scroll your students' screen so that they can see the area you're directing them to. The zoom tool will zoom your view only, not the student's view. This is because they might be using a device with a different size screen. This button will delete whatever selected, but personally I just hit backspace or the delete key because it's faster. Finally, we have the clear all button, which clears all your annotations. You will get a warning before it does this, which I know from personal experience is a lifesaver. So that's the quick overview. We also have some more in-depth videos coming up next on the Classroom Training playlist.